The Grymwatch are a band of deluded flesh-eating ghouls that believe they're on a quest to slay a monstrous beast that dwells at the heart of the mountain. In this video, we're going to show how to paint a couple of these models. We're going to be starting with Duke Crackmarrow. Following that, we're going to paint in his fellbats known as the Harriers. However, by following this painting guide, you'll easily be able to paint any other model in the warband. So grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the models. And as you can see here, I've undercoated Duke Crackmarrow using Wraithbone and the Harriers, also known as the Fellbats, with Mechanica Standard Grey. Now we're going to start by base coating the skin on Duke Crackmarrow. And for this, we'll be using Death Guard Green. So I'm going to give the pot a quick shake, pop it open, and then we're going to be using a medium base brush to apply this to his skin. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit onto the palette, like so. A little touch of water, not too much, just so it's not too thick and goopy. And I'm ready to start base coating it. Now, whilst we're base coating, you'll notice you've got some bone details on there. So if you do manage to get any paint on that, just tidy back up your Wraithbone once you're done. There we are, with the skin now base coated and any bone areas tidied back up with Wraithbone, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply a shade. Now for this, we'll be using a Thonian Camera Shade, and we're going to be thinning it down with Lamy Medium. We're going to use two parts Lamy Medium to one part a Thonian Camera Shade. So I'll apply the Lamy Medium first, just so I don't contaminate the pot. So two paintbrushes of that, and then just one paintbrush of a Thonian Camera Shade. A little bit more, because I didn't get enough on there. Once I've loaded that up, we're then ready to start applying that all over the skin. There we are, with the shade now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to layer up the skin. Now for this, we'll be using Nurgling Green, and I'll be using my small layer brush for this. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette like so, and again, just a slight touch of water, not too much, just so it flows better, and we can get a nice point to that brush as well. And we're ready to start layering that up. Now I'm going to start on the head first, so I'm going to do things like the cheeks, the nose and stuff, but we still want some of that Death Guard Green and a Thonian Camera Shade showing through. With the Nurgling Green now layered on, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to highlight using Deepkin Flesh. Now for this, we're going to use the same brush. Just going to apply a little bit to the palette like before, and a little touch of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. Key bit here is to make sure you get a nice point to your brush, and then we're ready to start highlighting. I'm going to start on the face again. I'm just going to start picking out some of those raised details like the nose, and also the eyebrows and the cheeks. There we are, with the skin now done, we're going to move on to painting the next area, which is the bone. Now for this, we're going to start with Skeleton Horde, and we're going to thin this down with Contrast Medium. After that, we'll be using Gorgon to Fur, also thin down with Contrast Medium. After that, we're going to tidy back up, or re-layer, using a Wraithbone. And then finally, we'll use Pallid Witch Flesh as a highlight as well. So first of all, let's start with that Skeleton Horde. So I'm going to apply a couple of dollops of Contrast Medium. So I'm just going to use two, and then a dollop of Skeleton Horde. Just mix that together. We don't want it too strong, so all I'm going to do is just load my brush up, and I'm ready to start picking out all those bone details. So all I'm going to do here is just start applying that on. Now once it's dry, if you want a bit more depth, you can always add a little bit more Skeleton Horde on after, just in some of those deeper recesses. With a thinned down Skeleton Horde now applied and dry, we're going to apply Gorgon to Fur, which has also been thinned down with the same ratio. Now we're just going to drop this into those deeper recesses. This will give it a nice warm feel to it, but also a bit of a wet look that you expect from the ghouls. With the Gorgon to Fur now dry, we're going to be using Wraithbone just to start highlighting those areas closer to the tips of the bone, like so. Let's just add a bit more definition when we start doing the final highlight. And finally, we're going to finish the bone off by using Pallid Witch Flesh. Now we're just going to keep this to the tips of the bone and also any raised areas like on the skulls, such as cheekbones, etc. Now that we've completed the bone, we're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the hair. Now I'm going to start by base coating all the hair using Mechanica Standard Grey. After that, we're going to shade with Norn Oil. Then we're going to highlight all the hair using Wraithbone. And only on some key areas like his beard, we're going to finish off a highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So I'm just going to apply a couple of dollops, a bit more like so, a little bit of water. Get our brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start base coating. So a couple of areas to pick out. So you've got his groin hair, stuff on his back as well, and then of course he's got his beard and a little bit of hair just going down the side of his head. Now that we've base coated the fur, we're going to shade using Norn Oil. Now on his groin and his back, we're going to coat all over, but on his beard, we're just going to keep it close to his chin like so, because we're going to be highlighting this area a lot lighter than the rest. With the shade now dry, we're going to move on to using Wraithbone. Now on his groin area, we're going to layer about halfway up, And then we're going to start picking out the highlights nearer the tip of his hair there. And on his back, we're just going to pick out the tips just down the spine. And his beard, we're actually going to start layering most of that except around where his chin is, so you've got a little bit more depth. So most of this area just around in the back, where his goatee, if you like, we're actually just going to layer most of that wraith bone till we get closer to his chin. Then we'll just start showing some of that darkness through, just to give some more definition. To finish the hair off, we're going to highlight those areas we've just coated with wraith bone with pallid witch flesh. Let's just give it a little bit more definition on some of those lighter tipped areas. With the hair now done, we're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the silver details. Now for this, we're going to start with iron warriors. We're then going to shade it using Norn oil. Then for any corroded areas or rust, we're going to apply a little bit of Gorgrunt of Fur. And finally, we're going to highlight using Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start applying that dark metal of iron warriors. I'm just going to apply a couple of dollops, a little bit of water, get a nice point to the brush, and then we're ready to start doing it. So the main area we're going to focus on is his axe, but he's got a couple of piercings across his body as well. He's got a little ringlet on his leg and then a hook just around the back of his hair. Next, we're going to apply Norn oil all over those metal areas. Take your time and try not to overload your brush too much. With the Norn oil dry, we're now going to apply Gorgrunt of Fur to any of the pitted, rusty areas you can see on the axe here. It's also worth just dropping it into some of the deeper recesses as well on other weapons or other bits of metal. With the rust now done, we're going to move on to highlighting, and for this we're using Stormhost Silver. So all we're doing is just trying to pick out the edges like so. Most places you just use the edge of your brush and just run it along any edges. There we are with the silver details now done. We're going to move on to painting the dark brass details. This is mainly going to be on the shaft of his weapon. We're going to start by painting a warblock bronze. We're then going to layer it with Cycorax bronze. In the recesses, we're just going to shade with Norn oil and finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start base coating that warblock bronze. So just apply a little bit to the palette again. A little touch of water. Get a nice point and we're ready to start doing it. What I'm going to do is just start gently running that on. Now, if I do get any warblock bronze on the straps here, I'll just tidy back up with wraith bone. With the base coat now applied, we're going to start layering with Cycorax bronze. In some of the areas where there's like some little cuts or dents, I'm just going to leave the warblock bronze showing through. With his weapon half now layered, we're going to apply Norn oil all over. And what this is going to do is just going to add a bit more definition to those pitted areas or like cracks and dents, but also just knock some of that shine off so it just looks a little bit old and weathered. That shade now dry, we're going to use Stormhost Silver just to pick out any of those dents just by running a little bit of the Stormhost Silver just around the edges just to really emphasize them. And there's just this little bit here, we're just going to pick that out by running Stormhost Silver around it as well. There we are with the dark metal now done. We're going to move on to painting some other details, which is going to be the leather straps on the model and his eyes. Now, I'm going to start with the leather straps first by picking them out with Gorgrunt of Fur. We're then going to highlight them with wraith bone. Whilst doing that, we're going to pick out the eyes using wraith bone as well. I'm going to finish off the eyes by applying Blood Angel Red. But first of all, let's start with that Gorgrunt of Fur. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Not too much, mind. Just add a little touch of water there, just get a nice point to a brush. Just run it in like so, and then we're ready to start picking out those straps. Now, there's not too many on this particular model. There's just some on his weapon and on his wrist as well. So just apply the contrast paint and then just wait for it to dry before doing the highlighting. With that contrast now dry, we're going to use wraith bone to pick out some of the edges on it. And also, we're going to pick out the eyes using the same colour as well. With the straps highlighted and the eyes picked out, we're now going to use Blood Angel Red just to get those eyes nice and red and emphasised. Just drop it in a little bit and you'll see that when it starts to dry, the wraith bone will start to show through as well, which give it a nice highlight. There we are with the eyes now picked out. We're going to move on to painting the base. Now we're going to start by picking out the stonework, and for this we're going to be using Mechanica Standard Grey. For any dirt or soils on the base, we'll be using Gorgrunt of Fur, and after that we're going to shade all over with Norn oil. First of all, let's start picking out that stonework. I'm just going to use Mechanica Standard Grey, like I said, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. And I'm also using a medium layer brush for this as well. And all we're going to do is then start picking out those flagstones and also the pillar that you stood on as well. With the stonework now picked out, we're going to use Gorgrunt of Fur just to pick out any soil and dirt. There we are, the mud now picked out. We're going to use Norn oil and we're going to apply this to both the stonework and the mud. Take your time, try not to overload your brush so it swarms too much over the base, but if you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. There we are with that Norn oil now applied and dry. We're going to move on to doing the final part of the base, and this is to dry brush Carrick stone over both the stonework and the mud. So what I'm going to be doing is using my small dry brush. It's going to get a little bit on the brush like so, not too much, like that. And I'm just going to start rubbing it off. Now just keep doing this, probably in circular motions, probably the best thing to do. And you keep doing this until there's any trace amounts. Now the best way to find this out is just to find a clean piece of tissue and just gently rub it, and you can see just a little bit of paint coming off. That's perfect. So what we're going to do now is then we're going to start actually just rubbing this actually across the stonework and also the dirt, and you'll see it just starts to pick out on the edges. So just do this all the way across the base. There we are with the base now done. Duke Crackmarrow is pretty much finished. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to painting the Harriers or the Felbats, because there's a couple of shared elements on these, which include the bat's wings as well as the actual bits of flesh hunk that he's dragging around with, which will feature on other ghoul models as well. We're going to start with the black of the wings and the bats themselves. We're going to start by using Carrick Stone as a dry brush all over Mechanica Standard Grey. Following this, we're going to coat them over with Black Templar. Then we're going to pick out highlights using Dawnstone, followed with Administratum Grey. But first of all, let's start with that dry brush. So I'm just going to get some Carrick Stone again, like we just did in the previous stage. Just apply it to my tissue like so, and just keep rubbing it until most of it's come off. Then we're ready to start rubbing that actually onto the wings and the actual bats themselves. So what I'm going to do, I'll start from the back because it's a lot easier to see. So all I'm going to do is just gently rub that across. This is almost like a pre-highlight before we start applying the contrast paint. So all I'm going to do is just coat over all the elements of both the bat's wings and the bat's bodies themselves. There we are, that dry brush now done. We're going to move on to applying Black Templar over the body and the wings. I'm just going to apply this quite heavily on. Now, if you do find it pulling some of those recesses, just use your brush to soak up any excess. With the Black Templar now applied and dry, we're going to move on to using Dawnstone. And in some places, we're going to layer this, and others, we're going to highlight. So around the belly, just going to layer it on like so. When we get to around some of the things like the wings and the arms, I'm just going to be doing a fine edge highlight. There we are with the Dawnstone now applied. We're going to finish off with a highlight of Administratum Grey. So you're just looking for raised areas, such as like details on the face like so, and any other raised areas on the body. There we are with the skin and the wings of the Felbats now done. We're going to move on to the final detail, which is to pick out any flesh details. Now on the base, this model has got a big chunk of flesh that's being dragged along, so we're going to start base coating that. Now we're going to start by using Cadian Flesh Tone. We're then going to coat that in Gulliman Flesh after, then tidy back up with Cadian Flesh Tone, just as like a highlight, then finish off with Wraithbone. And then just to emphasise that gore, we're going to use some Blood for the Blood God. But first of all, let's start applying that Cadian Flesh Tone. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so again. Little touch of water. Now you want to do a couple of coats of this because it is a layer paint. So I'll just get a nice point to my brush and then ready to start painting. So what I'm going to do is just coat that over. With having a grey undercoat, it shouldn't be that much of a problem. With the Cadian Flesh Tone now applied, we're going to coat over using Gulliman Flesh. There we are with the contrast paint now dry. We're just going to tidy back up using Cadian Flesh Tone. So you're just looking to pick out any raised areas, leaving that contrast paint in the recesses. With the Cadian Flesh Tone now layered, we're going to finish off with highlighting with Wraithbone. So all we're aiming to do is just pick out some real raised areas, such as like spine bits, fingertips, stuff like that. So don't go too mad. We're now going to finish off by applying any gore to the gore details. Also, on Duke Crackmarrow, he's got some blood dribbling down from his face as well. And for this, we're using Blood for the Blood God. There we are, with the blood and gore done on the flesh, all that's left to do is paint the chains, the teeth, and the base. Now, all you need to do is just follow any methods in the Duke Crackmarrow paint guide. And also, don't forget to paint the rim of the base in the colour that matches your board. With the models now painted and based, they're ready to head off into the beast grave to seek fame and glory. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlighting, try and get a nice sharp point to your brush. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And also when using contrast paints or shades, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Grymwatch Warband, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.